an attitude and actions. We now take the privilege to invite none other than our very own chief guest, a guest for the state of Punjab, to come forward and address us all. Honorable Chief Minister of Puducherry, Shri.V.Narayanasamy ji.
Honorable Minister from Punjab, my dear brother, whose personality, not only in India, all over the world, everybody has been enjoying. Shri Navjot Singh Sidhu ji. Madam, Honorable Navjotkar Kaur Sidhu ji, our chairman of the ABJ group of institutions, Shri Aditya Berlia ji, the Secretary General Asmon, Shri Gautam ji, friends, ladies and gentlemen, it's a difficult task for me to address you when Sidhu ji is on the dais, because he has been a very fine personality, a person who has been encouraging the youth of India, who want the younger generation has to take the mantle. Nowadays I found in politics only a section of people coming into politics. Sometimes they feel that area is not acceptable to them because of the wrong picture that has been painted about politicians on the one side. On the other, they are attracted towards achieving something in the society. In fact, I am not from a political family. By sheer hard work, commitment to the leadership and the people, the recognition came step by step. Today's youth, they are in a hurry. They want to achieve something. They can achieve in various fields. There are various avenues available for youth in this country. In fact, there is a vacuum that is being created in political arena for the youth because the politicians wanted to promote their kith and kin. It is very unfortunate. The talented people should come. The committed people should come. They should come to serve the nation, serve the people of the state where they are working. But that I am not seeing today, because I accepted this invitation because I wanted the field of politics is open to common man, common people who want to serve the public, who wanted to take the cause of the poor and downtrodden. In fact, for a long time I've been in politics. I've been in parliament for more than 23 years. I've seen ups and downs in politics. I've been working with the Honorable former Congress President, the UPA Chairperson, Madam Sonia Gandhi as Secretary of the Congress Party and General Secretary of the Congress Party. Now, we are working under the leadership of our youth, dynamic, a visionary leader, our Honorable Congress President Shri Rahul Gandhi. Let me share few of my experience which I had with him when I was General Secretary of the party. I extensively toured with him to several states. I went to Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Orissa, Rajasthan and other states. One thing which touched my heart about his concern for the poor and downtrodden was an occasion where night at 11 o'clock in the night, on one day when Rahulji was staying in a remote guest house, I had a call from him that Narayanasamyji, we have to go to a place, will you come? I said, yes, I will come with you, sir. He left all the security people outside. Only one man was with him, along with his secretary and myself. We went in a jeep to a remote village in Bethul district of Madhya Pradesh. Remote forest area, which is 20 kilometers from the headquarters, where the people of scheduled tribe, the Adivasi people, were living. That is at 9, 11 o'clock we started. It was a kacha road. We went in the jeep. Only 4 people were there. The people were going with lantern in their hands to reach the destination. We had interaction with the people there. Rahulji had an interaction with them. They gave him at night 12 o'clock dalia, which has been prepared by them. They had no water, no hospital, no school. The children, they have to go 20 kilometers for studies. That was the rural India. I saw the concern of Sri Rahul Gandhiji. And there he told the government that these people have to be provided with all the basic amenities. That is Rahul Gandhi, who did not go to the big industrialist and businessman, who goes to the root of the problem which India is facing, is the scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and minorities and backward classes. I was really thrilled. I was touring all those areas. But when Rahulji interacted with them, he gave them the solace to those people. And thereafter, the water facility, road expansion, the school and hospitals were provided there by the government. Why I'm telling this? There should be somebody to take care of the welfare of the society which has been neglected by all sections. Today, lot of aspirations are there for younger generation. My advice to you, the youth have to come to politics. But in politics, we have to go step by step. You should not be in a hurry. Because I heard a very best example from Sri Sitaram Kesari, who was a long-term treasurer of the Congress party. I used to meet him frequently. He gave me one advice, which is a valuable advice, even today I am following it. He told me, Narayanasamyji, politics is like a fire. If you go nearby, you are finished. If you are far away, due to cold, you will suffer. Therefore, enjoy the warmth. You enjoy the warmth, you always be in limelight. Therefore, when you enter politics, you will get more enemies than friends, as now those Sindhu is getting. Enemies will be more, because they cannot compete, but they will try to destroy you. But you have to come out of it, and you should become victorious. That person will survive in politics. Right or wrong, one should be in the limelight. This is the quality of the leaders we have seen in our lifetime, because as far as now, there is a huge gap. Huge gap is being created in the society for the younger generation to come. Slowly, old generation is fading away from politics. Now the vacuum is to be filled. Vacuum is to be filled by competent people. The people who are coming to politics, they should feel that they come here for with some purpose, for the service of the nation, for the service of the people. Not only that, they should come with a vision. They should not come blindly, because father is a rich man. If I go to politics, I can capture power. It is not possible. It will not survive for long. It can be for a limited period. But surviving in politics requires hard work, sincerity, commitment to the leadership, commitment to the nation. Young, the students from all important institutions are there, you are here. I was in charge of science and technology in Government of India. Whenever the officers come and brief me, even scientists come and brief me, I think as students of IIT, IIM and other research institutions, you will also feel the same. When I talk to the officers, sir, we have done this research. We have submitted this thesis. And by this, the country will become the totally technology oriented. The research paper has been prepared, submitted, accepted. The technology has been approved, but taking it to the land. From the theory to make into action, from lab to land, it takes years and years together. They are not able to see the result. The research is for what? The research is for the purpose of facilitating the people to adopt the technology, not for the purpose of keeping it on paper only. Therefore, young budding scientists who are here, I would like to tell you that you should become the tool for the purpose of technology being to be adopted within a short span of period, so that the people will definitely enjoy the fruits of it. Today in our country, the people, upper caste people, the people who are in a higher state of society, the rich people are 9 to 10%. The middle class, lower middle class and poorer sections of the society is 90% population. We find what is happening day to day in our society. Agrarian distress, farmers are committing suicide, as far as the demonetization, totally destroyed small and medium industries in the country. And due to demonetization, the growth rate has come down by 2%. Then the minorities have no protection. The right wing, the writers, they are not able to express their views freely. Then there comes to the question of the people are being targeted, the media is being targeted. There is overall, if you see what is happening in the country today, the youth of the country, you have to rise up to the occasion for the purpose of correcting the wrong that is being done by in the society for the people. Whichever may be the government, I am not going to the politics in that. The woman should get protection. Dalit protection should be there. Minorities should feel that it is our country. The farmer suicide has to be stopped. Who has to do that? The people who are in power, they have to do it. Though ours is a small country, small state, Puducherry, I am coming from a place. It is an agriculture state. 2 years I am a chief minister there. My first priority was the maintaining law and order. Ours is a crime-free state. We were able to achieve it in our state. The adjoining state of Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, there is farmer suicide. But in our state, they totally, because of the policy of our government, compensating the farmers, waiver of farmers loan, apart from that, insuring the farmers crop, giving the drought relief to the farmers, not even a single farmer died in my state. We got award from India Today, from the India Today, for 5 awards I received as a Chief Minister of State in the first year of my government. One is maintenance of law and order. Second is organic farming. Third is the best tourism state. Fourth is the administrative reform. Fifth is police reform. The bigger state like Uttar Pradesh, they were blank. There is also elected government. Because the people who are coming to power, they should not be power mongers. They should feel they are common man. They are serving the common people. Only with that observation, the people will be able to prove their mettle as a chief minister, as ministers in a government. I know the job is very difficult. We have to balance. We have to carry everybody. As Sitaram Kesari ji said, we'll have to see that we don't go near the fire, don't be away from the fire. Therefore, we have to keep a balance. But even then, when you have a goal, you have to achieve that goal by step in our life. Today, I'm very happy that the students who came from all over the country, because this is a unique experience I'm finding, because I myself and Sidhuji also address several meetings. It's a unique experience for me as a chief minister, as a minister in government of India, because the vision comes from the youth. The aspiration of the youth is very important. Because today, because of Rahulji came to my state also, he had interaction with the university students. He had interaction with several the businessmen and industrialists. Because only when we interact with you, what is your aspiration, what is your wish, what we have to do for the country, and then when you become, what you will have to do, that is more important for the society to understand. Because we are one nation, one country, we may be different religion, different caste, different creed, but the India is one. We'll have to see that our country is far foremost important than the political system. Political system comes second, because only when the nation is there, political party is there. Therefore, nation is first for us. My advice to all of you, to keep the Indian nationalism as a spirit, and whichever possible way, by whosoever would like to come to politics, you all join together, get together, and try to develop this country, because our life is very short. The future is in your hands, and you'll have to take the mantle. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir.
कहते हैं कि साथ मिलकर किसी भी चुनौती को पार किया जा सकता है, चाहे वो समुद्र से गहरी हो या आसमां से भी ऊंची. आज एपीजे सत्य मॉरल